Hi everyone, this is Josh from Unito. Today I'm going to show you how to sync Notion pages with events in Google Calendar. It's pretty straightforward. As you can see here, I have a very basic page in Notion with an empty Google Calendar that will be populated with data from this page. So the first thing I'll do is, in the Unito app, select Create Flow. And this takes us to the Flow Builder. It's a five-step process to connect your tools and sync data between them. The first thing we'll do is hit this drop-down menu to select our tools. We'll put Notion on the left, Google Calendar on the right. The order doesn't matter. It's whichever you prefer. And then you have to connect your account. I've already done that. If you've not done so, the first time you go through that process, you simply have to authorize each tool in Unito so that the app has access to the data you'd like to sync. So I'll choose the Marketing Roadmap page in Notion and my calendar in Google Calendar, which I've labeled Marketing Roadmap as well, just to keep things simple. There it is. And then I'll hit confirm. And you'll notice that I have a bunch of different fields here, different types in Notion. So I've got a text field for campaign name. This will be the title of my events. I have tags and campaign types. So those are multi-select and single select fields. And that's very useful for setting rules. And first I'm going to set a flow direction here. So from the Notion marketing roadmap to my marketing roadmap test calendar, we'll set a one-way sync, and what that means is that anything added to my Notion page could appear as an event in Google Calendar, but not the other way around, which is important in this case because I'm sending new items I create in Notion to Google Calendar and not the other way around. But as you'll see, once those events are created, they'll be maintained in a two-way sync between Notion and Google. So here I'll set rules. And this is how I can filter out some events from appearing in Google Calendar if I wanted to be very specific and only share certain rows from this Notion page. So as I was mentioning, the multi-select and single-select fields are very useful for this purpose. So I could choose either tags or campaign type in this case. So campaign type is my single-select field, and I have a bunch of different options here. I'll choose all the ones that you see on screen, and we'll see which ones appear in Unito. So I've got not applicable for our internal event because it's not a campaign type, in-app, digital, social, and these are all fields named by me. Obviously, everyone's use cases are different, so you can name yours whatever you like, but using single select or multi-select fields for this purpose is really efficient. It makes it a lot easier to set rules to filter out certain events from appearing. Another thing I'll do just for the purposes of our demo is remove this condition here. This is a safeguard in every Unito flow. It simply tells Unito not to sync items created before the date in which you create the flow. That way you can try adding, say, a row here in Notion after you've launched your flow and see what that looks like in Google Calendar. I'm going to remove it just so that you can see these four items I've created appear instantly during the demo. Then I'll hit confirm, and now I'm going to choose my field mappings. In every Unito flow, you can tell Unito if you'd like your fields to be auto-mapped, or you can start from scratch if you prefer a DIY approach. I'll show you what happens with auto-mapping, but as you'll see, with Notion and Google Calendar, it's not the most efficient, simply because I've named all of my fields in Notion, so Unito doesn't know which of these fields instinctively belong with certain fields in Google Calendar. Except for this one, link to page with description footer, so that a link to the Notion page will appear in my description footer of the event. So I'll choose the mappings that matter the most for the purposes of this demo and to keep it brief. So I've got end date with end date. I'll sync my start date with start date, obviously. So I'll choose that here. Then the event name. So campaign name with title, so that when they appear in Google Calendar, I'll know which one is which. They won't just appear as a no name. And then I'll select the owner in Notion, the user, and then that person can become either the guest, the creator, the organizer. I'll set them as a guest, but it's obviously whichever you prefer. And then another thing I'll do is just add a little bit of customization here so that the tags I've chosen can add a bit of color to Google Calendar, as you'll see. I'll click this little gear icon, and this allows me to add a little bit more customization. So if I hit this bar here, add more tags and colors, I can specify which tags specifically should have their own color in Google Calendar. And this just adds visibility to your calendar, you know, makes it a little bit prettier as well. So let's say my awareness events will be banana, So they'll appear yellow in Google Calendar, even though the calendar itself, I believe I chose a shade of orange. You'll see what that looks like in a moment. Let's say my outreach activities can be a shade of blue. Let's go with blueberry. And I'll leave the last ones alone so that you'll see the difference between the different kinds of events. So this is a very basic workflow between Notion and Google Calendar. I'll just hit confirm. Each of those fields is now synced. So any changes I make in either one, once the flow is launched, will appear in the other. That's the benefit of having a two-way sync with Unito. So I've just hit launch flow. So the system is now going to search through Notion, try to identify these items, and then populate my calendar with the ones that I've chosen and specified via my rules. This process could take maybe 15, 30 seconds or so. So I might speed up this demo a little bit and then show you what it looks like when they're fully synced. So the flow is currently syncing. Unito is looking for changes. And any moment now, we should see those events appear. Okay, so it's tracked one of them. And there we go. So as you can see, this one here in orange is the traditional color for the calendar I've chosen. This one down here, the e-marketing push, is in yellow or banana, so that my team will know when a certain type of event is happening, in this case, an awareness event, and the duration, but they're both part of the same calendar. And over here, I've got my community growth, social outreach for the month of October, a product launch over here, as you can see, on October 3rd. And that's it. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out and let us know. Thanks for watching.